Hi friends, this is Pavani. Today we can see the topic data in Excel. Here in data we can print external data. If you want to import the data to your Excel, so how to do? Here we can see from web if you want, or from notepad if you want to insert in your Excel, we can do here with the help of this a data menu bar. From web, here we have the options from access, web and text, all those. See, we can take some points here. See, from web if you want, just select the from web. Here it is a URL address, so just I'm taking the address here, I'm relating. For example, if you want to insert the data in your, means the web address, if you want to insert in your Excel, we too can do. For example, I need time, or else just press the cursor here in your address. Okay, date and time, if you want, just I'm selecting here date and time. Okay, so date and time select here, it will be display. Like this. So select import, the total web address will be inserted in your Excel. If you want to see the, and it is asking existing worksheet, means if you want to select in this, or else if you want to select a new worksheet, we have to select only here. And it is asking the place in A3. Okay, so total web design, web data will be inserted in your Excel. Here total data will be inserted. Now we can see, like I say, sports means like cricket. If you want to see the score, if you want to do with the help of this, we can do. Here we have inserted the date and time. So here we can see the date and time where it is. Here it is the Monday. Okay. So if you want to insert all those, we can say, for example, if you have a date. See, here we have the date, total date also we have here. The total web address we can see here, like this. Means the total, whatever the web details we have inserted, so we can see in your Excel, means total data if you want. Okay, we can do here. Here, like this. It's 16:23, like time also. Okay, this is the time. Here, if you want to see the time, or else if you want to see the date, all those, we can see with the help of this web address. Now, and after inserting, if you want to change the date also, means date, not date, if you want to change the time, for example, it is 16:23, means if you want to see as 16:30 or 16:25, you can keep the seconds, means settings you can do here. For example, here we have seen, just place the cursor near next cell. For example, you place the cursor here, we can't see the external data options. So place the cursor near next cell. Okay, go to here. See, select here, we can place the here properties. Okay, just select the properties. Once again, whenever you place the cursor, we cannot able to see the options in external data, so we don't want that. If you want to change the time in your sheet, means for example, if you want to how much the time it is now, you want to see that, just select here properties. Okay, in connections, just select the properties. Here we can see the refresh every 60 minutes, or else if you want every 1 minute, all those. So if you want to do that, just click here refresh every, how much means how many minutes, if you want to, after how many minutes you want able to see the date. For example, here just select here 50 minutes or 66 minutes, or if you want to do that, select it. Okay, click on OK. If you want to do, we can able to see after every 60 minutes the time will be refreshed. So if you want to refresh, just refresh all. Okay, we can able to see the date. It is 16:23. See, here it is now 16:26, means whenever you refresh it, we can able to see the time here. And if you want the text, means from notepad, text is nothing but it is a notepad data if you want to insert in your Excel. So if you want to do that, same process. See, whenever you want to click this, we can't able to do. Why? Because with the cursor is on your web address. So place the cursor in empty cell. Okay, go to text. Okay, whatever the data you want to insert, means notepad if you want to insert, where your document has been placed in desktop, or else any drives if you are placed, just select your desktop or the notepad name you have given, right? So select it, click on import. See, here we can select the whatever the data we have written. So here we have written just select here fixed width and click on finish. That's all. That it is asking the cell number. We are in C13. Click on OK. That's all. Now go and see in your original. Same the matter will be there. Just video provides. That's all. So if you are changing the data, means whatever the data you are changing in your notepad. So for example, this I am copying and pasting here for a twice like this. Okay, close it. While closing, it will ask save. Now go to your Excel. See, it has only the matter here, right? So if you want to refresh whatever the matter you have written in your notepad, you want to refresh, means automatically it want to change in your Excel also. And that time go to properties, okay, and select here we select here properties and refresh, means if you want to refresh every minute or every hour, if you want to do, just select here, okay, and remove the tick mark in prompt for the file name. Okay, remove it and click on OK. It will be refresh, means select here refresh all. So whatever the data you have refreshed, means whatever the data you have modified in your notepad, we can do, we can see here. See, same the data we can see here also. So this is nothing but the data if you want to import from notepad or else from web, if you want to import in your Excel, we can do all this. Okay, and next we can see here filtering. If you want to filter, means for example, if you want to give the filter option to your table or else if you want to see ascending and descending. So if you, for that you need to apply any tables, means for example, if you are doing any data. See, we are taking another sheet here. For example, we are taking the employee details, employee name, okay, like this, designation. You take any example, whether it may be product details or student details or anything. So depends upon that, we can select the sorting and filter. So designation, take this designation here. And if you want any salary heading, if you want to, for example, I'm writing here salary. So here write the employee name, just I am taking here ABC, that's all. Select here, okay, like this. Designation, so what are the designation belongs to your employee, just mention the designation here. For example, like this. I am taking some options here. See, just I'm clicking here, copying and paste. And apply the salary also. Okay. Like this. Here, if you want to select as per your designation or as only the required employee name, if you want to select, we can do with the help of the filter. Or else if you want to ascending or descending also, we can do. So just I am applying the bold, that is Control B. Okay, Control I for the italic and Control U for the underline. This I have done here. Now, you want to give the filter only for your required, means only for the designation if you want to give, or else only for the employee name if you want to do. See, now first select for which you want to assign the filter button. Just select the column here, go to filter. Okay, the only the filter will be applied for only for your selected one. For example, we can see now here we can see there we have seen employee name, designation and salary. So if you do, if you want to only required, means I need only the sales manager details only, or else if you want only the service manager details only, all those if you do that, means under required designation only if you want to able to see, at that time we can select the filter option. So if you want to do that, first before that we need to select designation, means the column we need to select. Select here filter. Once again, for example, we are selecting here filter. See, it will apply for all those. Only required if you want, select the column, particular column you can select, click on filter. Here in filter we can see all those. See, designation here. Now the hand symbol we can upsee here, we can see it. Just select here the whatever the designation has been applied, manager, sales manager and service manager. If you don't require the total the designation, just remove the tick mark from there. Just I am removing the tick mark manager, sales manager. We have seen only the service manager. Just click on OK. See here, the only the service engineer, sorry, so not service manager, service engineer details only we can see. The remaining we can't. Okay, so this is the filter. Just select the here filter option, click on select all. If you want all, select click on select all, click on OK. We can able to see all those. Or else if you want only required, for example, they remove the tick mark sales manager and remove the tick mark service engineer. Only the manager if you want, click on OK. Only the manager we can see the details. So this is the use of your filter. Just select here, this one. So this we can do. If you want to remove, just select here, remove the filter. Ascending and descending if you want. For example, A to F. If you want F to A, just select the column here. Sort, if you want sort A to Z, it is in A to Z position. So if you want Z to A, just sort it. See like this, F to A. Like this we can do. It will change total overall the table. Okay, the total overall the table will be moved to ascending and descending options. And here, text to columns. If you want the data, for example, here I have given here. Select this text to columns here. Means the two, for example, you have written the miss by mistake in a single cell. The two names here, Bala and space I am giving, it has been XYZ. So these XYZ, if you want to move to next cell, if you want to do, place the cursor, go to text columns, okay, click on finish. Understood? Just see carefully. Just directly I am showing text to columns, click on finish, it is not moving. So what we need to do, select the cell, text to columns, fixed width, okay, like this. So these we can select it. So next again I will say you, for example, here we have written sales space manager. Means after the space the word it is there, that word will move to the next cell. In that time we can use the text to columns. For example, this manager, if you want to move to next cell, so place the cursor, go to text to columns, select here fixed width, okay, select here fixed width. The fields are aligned in columns with the space between each field. Means whatever the data you have given in your cell, after the space between the for example, after the sales it has been a space, means after that manager, the between the words space it is there, no, that will move to the next cell. So just click on finish. That is the text to columns. And next we can see here flash fill. Flash fill means, for example, here I have taken one sheet here. This is the first name. For example, if you want to take first name in one column and last name in next column, at that time we can use the flash fill. Here flash fill, if you want to do, just I am spacing the, place the cursor here. I am writing first here Kumar, means after the space Kumar. And next if you want to repeat like Singh, Konpaka and like Joseph, if you want to remaining also, just I want to copy this here like this. Okay, okay. So this second name, if you want to move to the next column, just select here. Okay, select here flash fill. Means depends upon the first cell requirement, the next cell also will be moved. For example, I am taking the last two words or three words. Just copy, paste. For example, MAR. Okay, select here flash fill. Means depends upon our particular, whether you take two letters or whether you take four letters, depends upon the particular cell, the remaining output will be appeared. Okay, so that is nothing but flash fill. Duplicates, if you want to remove, okay, from your sheet, you want to remove the duplicates. Means if you want only two names if you are repeated, or else designations if you are repeated, you want to remove the duplicates. So at that time we can select here. For example, here we have duplicates name. Okay, if you want to remove from our sheet, we can't go through each and every row and each and every column, we can't delete. So if you want to delete that, just select here remove duplicates. It is asking the columns heading name, and here we have given some headings here, mobile number and AME like this. So if you want to delete from all the subheadings, click on OK. See, three duplicate values formed and removed, five unique values remain. What it is saying, what the three times it has been delete, means three duplicate values has been founded and we have removed. That is nothing but do remove duplicate values. Means, for example, if you are writing any repeated values or as repeated letters, if you are writing words, if you want to remove it from your sheet, at that time we can use the remove duplicates. For that we need to select the data, means you want to select the data, remove duplicates. This remove duplicates, we couldn't do this for the selected range of cells. Select a single cell within a range of data and then try again. Again, I'm copying here. For example, I'm placing the cursor here. Remove duplicates. See, it is Anil Kumar two times. If you want to do, means if you want to delete that, click on OK. No duplicate values. See here. Why? Because it is the space between there. For example, if you want, I'm copying this. Copy and paste. So if you want to delete, okay, just select here remove duplicates. Means under name if you want to delete, or under a mobile number, or it is asking just what you want to do, just remove the tick marks. Under name if you want to delete, click on OK. It will be removed. See, like this. We are not seeing the same name repeated here. Only the four we have seen. This is nothing but remove duplicates. So we have seen the how to delete the duplicates values or else duplicate numbers, and how to add only for a particular column filter, all those we have seen. In letters, what we have seen, the if you want to import from Notepad or from web series, if you want to do, and after updating, if you want to update automatically whatever the data you have written in your Notepad, at that time you need to select refresh. So these are the topic we have learned, and we can see next topic tomorrow. Thank you.